Today's Mailbag Monday is assisted by Flirting with Goth Dark Ale from Bookstore Brewing in Winnipeg. In amongst the little story on the back, they describe it as having roasty calm, hints of spice and malt sweetness, and a light bitter finish. Spooky October beer. So the first package in says push-pull solenoid. Two solenoids, matter of fact. So these are little spring-loaded solenoids. It looks like they pull in or push in that direction when you energize them, and then they spring back. Okay. I wonder what the voltage on them is. I think that means 12 volts. But we'll go and check the listing just to be sure.
DC, 3 volt, 5 volt, 6 volt, 9 volt, 12 volt, push-pull solenoid, through-type electromagnet, stroke 4 millimeters. Got these for $2.75 each. And the ones I chose are, in fact, 12 volt. That looks like a pretty reasonable price compared to these other ones here. So I think I'm doing good so far. 4 millimeters, 7 grams, 0.2 newtons of thrust. They're rated for whatever voltage you buy. The 12 volt one is 400 milliamp draw.
Let's just try these. I got 12 volts on the power supply. Connect it up here. And actually, let's put that into current mode so we can see. So if we do that, yep, the little solenoid kicks in. Good. And when it pulls in, it's pulling 400 and some milliamps. That's just about exactly what it said. Nice. Nice quick action on it. Cool. These seem to be the kind that I was hoping to get. You remember several mailbags back, I got some other small solenoids, which were actually vacuum valve solenoids, and that didn't really help me for what I'm thinking of. But these ones, I think, may do the job for the tinkering that I had in mind. That tinkering is, now that I think about it, inspired by watching Look Mum No Computer. He's been working with a few different electromechanical music machine projects over the last several months, and I think that's what triggered me to pick these up. Those will show up in the future in a project. Also, I think I have some other solenoids that I've ordered and haven't received yet, so we'll maybe wait for those to come in, and then I'll have a few options to play with. Regardless, next item, which is components. Super unhelpful. Probably honest, but not really all that helpful. What kind of little module is this? Ah, it's an 8085 breakout board. This is kind of a clone of the Digispark boards, but not in the same form factor as the Digispark boards. Those Digispark boards came in that form factor, so you could just plug it straight into a USB. This has all the same components and the same functions, just in a slightly different package.
One piece new Digispark Kickstarter AT Tiny USB development board for Arduino. I got this one at auction for 99 Canadian cents with free shipping. I have several of these in stock already. I have used several of them. They're a good little board just for a simple project, and that's why I put such a lowball bid on it at auction and got it. Of course, since it was an auction, I will send you to this search link to find them. Make sure you sort price plus shipping lowest first to see what you can find.
Moving right along, the next thing in is, something that was sent to my P.O. box. It says accessories. Wonder what this anonymous package is. It is some perf board. These are another one of those consumables that you do tend to go through, and it's always good to have extras of them around here in various sizes. These are good for making a circuit permanent once you've developed it out on a breadboard and you just want to solder it down, but you don't want to go to the effort of designing up a proper circuit board and having it manufactured or manufacturing it yourself.
Since this was sent anonymously to my P.O. box, I will link you to this search term which finds them. Looks like you can get 5 of them at auction. Well, if you're lucky, for as low as 41 cents, but regular price $1.36 for 5 of them.
Moving right along, we have alligator clips, it says. Hmm. Looks like I have, yeah, some red ones and some black ones. This is another one of those things that I do tend to go through as I'm just making up random little test cables. So it's good to have a few more on hand. There's a lot of different styles. Some are better than others. These ones, again, they're not the highest quality ones. They're not from Canon ITT or anything, but they definitely do the job.
10 pieces small insulation boot metal alligator clip electric test crocodile. Looks like the listing's ended, but if you search for that, you should be able to find others. Anyway, I paid a whole $1.96 Canadian for the 10 of these things with 11 cents shipping. So, yeah, as you can see, there's no reason to treat these like they're made of gold or anything. But just for a short-term use test setup, they're perfectly fine. They're made out of plastic and metal. There's not much else to say about them down here.
And the last thing in is another thing that came anonymously in my P.O. box. This says car atmosphere light. Not really a car light. This is a USB LED flashlight thing. This literally plugs into USB and it is a source of light. I suppose you could use it in the car, but you could also plug it into a little power bank and use it like that. I'm sure it draws almost no current. But we can easily test that and plug it into the power supply. Yeah, 54 milliamps, so negligible. It'll run forever on a power bank. Or you could plug it into a wall charger and just use it as a nightlight or something like that. Neat little thing. Thank you to whoever anonymously sent that along.
Once again, since this was anonymously sent, I will link you to a search term that finds these and several others that are very similar. Here's some down here that look exactly the same as the one that I've got for about, $273 for five of them. Okay, so they are super duper cheap. But there was only one in the package that I got, so I'm going to assume that whoever sent this got it at auction for much, much less than even these cheap prices. Thank you once again to whoever sends this stuff in. I appreciate it, and it's always fun to see what people think that I can make use of or want to have or need around here.
And there is the contents of today's quick little Mailbag Monday haul. Quite the assortment again. Got these neat little solenoids that I think may come in handy for doing some electromechanical kind of projects. I don't know. We'll see. Like I said, I haven't played with any of this kind of stuff for years and years and years, and I'm going to blame it on Sam from Look Mom No Computer for inspiring me to try a bit of electromechanical stuff. Then there's these perf boards, which the anonymous donor sent into my P.O. box. Always appreciate consumables like that because, you know, they're consumable and I too tend to go through them. There is this Tiny 85 board, which, as I said, I've bought many of these over the past and I've used them in various things. As a matter of fact, there's one in here that's controlling that right there. These clip leads, again, something that I tend to use on just temporary test fixtures and little jigs and leads and things that I make up around here. So always good to have more of those. And then there's this little light, this little USB light. I've got a few different variations on just directly USB plug-in lights. And they're all fun to play with. Again, I do like things that light up. That's always cool. And it's always neat to see the variety of different ones that are available. And it does make a good nightlight that draws very, very little current. So that's cool. Well, thanks everybody for watching and sticking around through this. I do appreciate that. Thanks to the anonymous donors who send stuff in, to the Patreon supporters who help keep the beer fridge full. Oh, look, it says Patreon right there. The YouTube channel members and everybody else who helps the place out. And just thanks for watching in general. I appreciate it. Questions and comments down below. I'll talk to you later.